Hi, welcome to an NX 11 video tutorial. I want to do the crankshaft, the derived variant, now in NX. So that's an assembly with the basic parts, then the segment part, and then there is a complete crankshaft. And there are also some expressions which are interpart expressions. And they control the complete crankshaft. So let's begin and have fun with Siemens NX. So I will start with the basic part. Let's go for a sketch on the ZX plane. And this will be the counterweight. I need a circle, and that circle would be 80 in diameter. Then another one which has 300 diameter. Okay, let's align those. Yeah. Like this. The distance from that point should be 35. Okay, and then I need a construction line. Which should be something like this. Make it for construction. And then align it. Collinear, yes. Trim. And the distance from that point to that point should be 167. Okay, then I need something like this. Make those tangent, like this, tangent. There should be an angle. This should be 40 degrees. You could go for symmetry, then I would have to delete some of these constraints, so I will go for another angle. So that angle right here should be 20. Distance should be 150. Close and trim. Okay, and of course I could delete those two as well, and trim right here. Close. Sketch is fully constrained. Yes, finish that sketch. And now make an extrude and make this one 20 millimeter in the other direction. Okay. And hide the sketches. So this will be my first solid, and it will get a name. But first I have to do another solid. The next sketch would be on this plane, the XY plane. And this looks something like this. Okay. Give it some dimensions. This would be 5. This distance would be 5 as well. And that distance would be 40. This distance should be 42. And this one should be 38. And this point right here with that axis, that point should be coincident. And of course that point should be on this axis as well. Coincident. Finish that sketch. Now make a revolve around that line. No, not that one, but that line should be the vector. Okay. And boolean is none. Hide the sketch. Go over here, right click, deactivate timestamp order, and you got two solids and they get a name. This one will be the counterweight. I will make a short CV, and that would be the intermediate IMBJ JB. Let me take a look. Yeah, it's the intermediate membrane junction, IMBJ. Okay. Now I could use the same sketch once more, so switch back to time step order, copy that sketch, and control V for paste, and just OK. Now let's go to that sketch right here and change the parameters. So 5 would be the same, but these two should be changed. This would be 24, and that should be 28. Okay, so now I could hide the bodies. Just show that sketch and make another revolve, and the vector would be this, that line right here. Okay, and confirm and hide the sketches. Switch back to without time stamp order, and this will be called that would be the connecting rod journal, so CRJ. need a flange and the front main bearing journal. Okay, so let's go for the bearing journal. Let's hide this one. Switch back to timestamp order. You don't have to switch back to timestamp order, but I find it convenient to do so. So that sketch would be again on that plane. And this looks something like this. Now give it some dimensions. This would be 150. That distance should be 5. This one should be 55. That would be 115. That distance would be 22. This one might be 30. That one might be 38, and this one could be 42. Okay, now this point should be coincident to that sketch origin. Finish that sketch, make another revolve with this one, and the vector should be that line. Okay, hide the sketch and make that body. Invisible. Now the flange, again a sketch on that plane, and this looks something like this. That distance would be 25. This would be 15. That distance could be 28. And the last one right here could be 55. And that should be 30. Okay, align those two points. Finish that sketch, make another revolve with that sketch around that axis right here. And okay, hide the sketches. Switch to the solids and rename. Last one should be the flange. No, that's not the flange. That's the flange. And this would be the MBJ main bearing channel. Just to make sure that's the main bearing channel. Okay. Those five bodies are right here in one place. Let's switch back to timestamp order. So if I want to use the wavelink, I have to go for an assembly. So let's go to assembly and put this part into an assembly. So I can create a new parent. An assembly, and that would be called the complete derived crankshaft. So that's my assembly, and these are my basic parts. Then I need a new part in that assembly. So that's active. So create a new part, and that would be the segment. I call it segment. And I don't want to add components, so just make OK. Then go to the segment and go to the wave geometry linker. And I want to link bodies. And I want to link that body. Apply. I want to link this body. Apply. And let's move over here and select the connecting rod channel. Apply. Then the MBJ. Apply. And the flange should be right there as well. The flange, apply, and this one, I need two of them, so I will apply it once more. Cancel this out. And now I have to move the parts into the right position. So maybe switch to that one. I got those linked bodies. And one of the counterweights has to move, and those IMBJ and the connecting rod channels have to move as well. So let's go to home, and I want to move an object. You can transform or move, and I want to move object. Okay, so that should be moved. Maybe I'll start not with this one, but with the, where is it, with the connecting rod channel, with this one. This should be moved in that direction. That would be the Y direction. So you could go for YC. And it should be moved not around an angle, but a distance. So you could select it like this. And the distance would be 40. And I want to move the original. Apply. And sorry, I made a mistake, not 40, but 20, of course, 20. And okay. and then it should be moved up in set direction. So move it once again. Same part, this one, same body, and it should be moved 40 in this direction. And make sure it's associative and apply. Next one would be now one of these counterweights. I will go for this counterweight and move it in that direction. 20 plus 40, so it's 60. Apply. Now that one, same direction, should be 20 plus 40 plus 20, so that's 80. Apply. And the flange, this one, should be moved 20 plus 20, 40, 40, that's 120, and there are five of them, so it should be moved 5 times 120. 5 times 120 in that direction. And okay. Let's take a look. Looks good to me. Now I want to unite those four solids. So go for unite this one with that one, this one and that one, and okay. So there's a unite. Let's switch. So that would be the segment. So I want to rename this one into segment. Flange and MBJ is still the same. Okay. Let's go back to our assembly. And I need a new part. So add, not add, but create a new, and that would be the complete crankshaft. Okay, and okay. Seems this one is not in the right place, so maybe I forgot to position it. So we'll go to my basic parts, deactivate those, and check. This one. That would be the MBJ. That's okay. So I might have one body too much. I'll go to my segment and check this. Counterweight, counterweight. This looks odd. What's that? These are the basic parts. And they're still visible. Yeah, of course. That's okay. Nothing wrong there. Okay, switch to the complete craft part. And now let's add those bodies with the wave geometry linker. And I need this one. Apply 5 times. Three, four, and five. Okay, now I need this one, and of course the flange. Okay, now I need to move those segments and rotate them. So go to the bodies. That's one segment, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, move this one, edit, move object, and this should be moved by 120 in that direction. Move the original associative, yes, apply. Next segment would be this one. Vectors same, and this should be moved 2 times 120. Apply. 1, 2, 3, the fourth one. This vector 3 times 480. Not 400, but 120, sorry. Apply, and the last segment should be moved. Same vector. You could, of course, use an axis, or the axis of the coordinate system doesn't matter in this exercise. That would be 4 times 120 in that direction. Okay. Now let's rotate those segments. So go for move, and I want to move the second one. I want to move it by an angle. Vector would be the YC axis, that's okay. And the axis point would be, of course, 0, 0, 0. And the angle would be 144. Apply. Next one would be the third one. Axis point would be the same as before. And that angle would be 216. Apply. Next would be this one. Point again is the same, and it should be angle should be 288. Apply, and the last one should be 72. Okay. Looks good. And I'm almost done. What I need now are the expressions. Okay, for my expressions, I will switch to my basic parts. go to Tools, Expressions. Not all expressions, but only user-defined expressions. I need a new one, and this will be called counterweight width. And this should be right now at the moment. Millimeters. Next one, another new one, would be the go to expressions. What is wrong? IMBJ. So somehow I deleted my counterweight width. That should be 20. And the IMBJ length should be 40. The C connecting rod channel length should be 40 as well. And there is a segment length. Segment length. And that would be the counterweight width, but two times plus the IMBJ length plus the connecting rod channel length. Let's check. Did I write it correct? IMBJ length. Yeah, there's an error. That should be a J, not a Y. Segment, not segment, but segment length. A G. J length, IMBJ length, and the counterweight width. Apply and OK. Now I have to put or insert those parameters into my model. So let's check. Switch back to time spin order, and that would be the first extrude. The end limit, this one, should be the counterweight width. That sketch, this should be the IMBJ length. That sketch, that 40 should be the CRJ length. Of course, you could go into the sketch and replace that value right here with that parameter. So I got both. Yeah, So I'm done in that part. Let's go to the segment. So that move commands need the segment parameter. And here it's called segment, really. Sometimes I'm a little bit tired. Okay. How to get those expressions into that part? Go for tools, expressions. Create multiple interpart expressions, only one, because right now I need only one. That would be the segment. Okay. And that parameter is in the basic parts. And that would be the segment length. And okay. I go for named expressions. Here's my segment length. And okay. And now I can use the segment length in that part right here. So go to the move commands. This one, oh no, I need all of them because that's the segment. Okay, go back to expressions and create more. I need all of them. I need the length, the width, and this length. Can use them all, and that first move command should have right there not a 20 but a formula, and that would be the counter weight width, this one. Okay, so just insert the counter weight width and okay. Next move command, right here, would be the connecting rod channel length. That move command would be the counterweight width plus the CRJ length, and the model should not change because these are the values which the model is right on at the moment. Next one, this would be, let's go into the command and go for the formula. And this one would be 2 times the counterweight width. This has the advantage that I got a autocomplete plus the CRJ length. And okay. And okay. Last move command would be that for the flange, and this should be 5 times the segment length. Segment length. So this does not exist because I made the same error as before, but this should exist. And it's done. Great. Let's go to our complete crankshaft. And there I need only the segment length. So go for tools, expressions, and I want to create a new interpart expression, and I need this one, the segment length. There you go, and OK, and OK. Now I can use the segment length right here. So I have to check those move commands, only the displacement in Y direction. So there should be the segment length. Next one should be 2 times the segment length. Okay. This one, 3 times segment length, and the last one is this one, 4 times the segment length, and okay. Now, sorry, if I change the expressions in the basic parts, my complete crankshaft should change. That's the idea. So let's go to the basic parts, go to the expressions, and for example, change the CRJ length from 40 to 50. And OK. So that has changed in my complete crankshaft. That's nice. Let's try another one. Maybe change the counterweight width to 30 or 40. Make it 40. Okay. And it works. And I'm done. So just one move is wrong. That one was wrong. So how to find this one? It's in the segment part. One move command is wrong. That should be, oh yeah, I know. So because that's one, that's okay. But that's okay. But this one is okay. That was the up movement, or is it? That's the move up, and that's over there, and that's the move up, and the move up is wrong. This should be 40 and not be linked to a parameter. That's okay. You see, it's very easy to find errors because it's very structured. Okay, I think I'm done. Hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page, and please like it. Would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.